we're actually allowed to take lumber from our fields and regrow, take lumber from under our environmental.
It's June the 20th, 2017, 2018. This is part two. Donald Trump in West Columbia, South Carolina.
And, you know, I see Justin saying we fought World War I together.
At Fort Husker.
We love Canada. Canada's charging almost 300% tariffs on dairy products and many other things. It's all working out great. And I said, look, if you want to do that, we're going to put a little tariff on your cars coming in. You know, cars are the big one. European Union, we lost $151 billion last year with the European Union. Sounds nice. Many of us originally came from somewhere in the European Union. I had two parents, European Union. So it sounds wonderful. Our country lost $151 million. They send the Mercedes, they send the BMWs, they send everything. We tax them practically nothing. We can't send our cars. And if we do, they charge many, many times the tax that we stupidly don't charge. So I told here's what we're going to do. We're going to charge a tariff on steel until such time as you straighten out your act and you let us have fair. They don't.
Yay.
They don't let our farmers into the European Union. It's very hard. So we have farmers that want to sell. You don't hear these stories. This is why with these people, they don't tell you these stories. The European Union has what they call trade barriers. The European Union doesn't allow go and trade. It's very hard for them to go trade. And if they do, it's very expensive. Same like Canada. Essentially, when you're paying a 275% tax, and now I'm understanding it's higher, but a 275%, that's essentially a trade barrier. You can't trade. How can we trade? We can't pay that kind of tax. So I want the barriers taken down. I want our farmers to be able to trade. I want to be able to sell cars today, just like they sell cars today.
That's right.
Because we're the piggy bank that they like to take from.
Right.
Whether it's military protection, you look at NATO. NATO, we're spending 90% of NATO. Now, it's all wonderful and we like to help out, but it helps them. They're in Europe. It helps them a lot more than it helps us. We're very far away. So we have this incredible. Germany is paying 1% of a much smaller GDP. So I think we should pay the same as Germany. I just think we should pay the same as Germany. So the fact is, we're getting some out of the bag because we came in there with all these problems. But I love it. I'm loving what we're doing. You people are loving what we're doing.
This is Jimmy.
And in all fairness,
I cannot believe that there is not one African American in here.
Our country lost $817
billion dollars.
Folks, we lost $817 billion. Who the hell can do that? Sort of stupid, don't you? And the biggest, of course, is China. China made anywhere, depending on the way you count, from $375 billion, we built China. And I really like President Xi, but we built China. And they did help us on the border with North Korea. They might not be helping us anymore, and that would be too bad. But that would be too bad. And I've been as nice as I can, as long as I can, but we gotta get some balance. And it doesn't have to be perfect, but there's gotta be some fairness. You know, I'm a believer in free trade, but I'm really a believer in fair trade. Because they know they're getting us out. How worth. We picked up anywhere from $7 to $9 trillion. We're almost twice the size of China's economy. Nobody knows that. If you sell a car into China from the United States, they charge you a 25% tax. If China sells a car into the United States, we charge them 2.5%. So it's 2.5% versus 25%.
Boo, China.
Somehow, looking at this rich guy right over here, that doesn't work for me. That's not a big worker, right? I'll bet you're a big successful. I can see the eyes. Big success. But that doesn't work too well, sir, does it? And we have many, many cases like that. We have many cases like that. So we're going to straighten it out. And they all want to negotiate. Because they have to negotiate. I mean, honestly, they have to negotiate. It has to happen. It's not like, that's not a threat. It's like the Iran deal. So bad. We paid $150 billion to sign a horrible agreement. We gave $1.8 billion in cash to pick up 4 hostages. Net worth of any hostage in history. We paid nothing, nothing to North Korea, and he did a very smart thing because it was goodwill, it was good. We did it before I even left. So, you know, there are a lot of good things, and a lot of good things are happening for us, and it's all going to work out. And it's going to work out because we have a big advantage. Because remember, we're the bank, and they're taking money from us hand over fist, but at some point that's got to stop. It's got to stop. We can lower your taxes, which we did. We gave you the greatest tax cut in the history of our country. We have some incredible things happening with healthcare. We got very badly hurt. We had all the bugs, and then one gentleman early in the morning, like 2 o'clock in the morning, he went home. Well, he campaigned when we were in the place. We had all the bugs. And he, perhaps he was playing standing. Who knows what he was doing? But you know what? He said, no, no. Everybody said, what the hell happened? He's been campaigning for 8 years, repeal and replace. And he didn't do that. But now, what we've done in the tax bill is we've gotten rid of the individual mandate. Just like this producer from Hollywood said, we're doing a real job. I don't